So, let's see, JT just rolled a sidekick, Black Widow. He feels Serena. He's got two bolts sitting with his magic missile, and he is threatening Mike with a Serena and a bunch of sidekicks. And Mike, of course, takes the 2 damage, so he's now at 18, and he's debating whether he wants to block with 3 sidekicks and kill the Serena, or 1 sidekick, or 0 sidekicks. What would you do, Michaela?
And he goes with 1 sidekick, just to keep the Serena in the field.
The question, though, is Serena in the field less dangerous than Serena not in the field?
I was wondering the same thing.
The problem is if he blocked with all 3, JT would just ping 1 with a magic missile, and then she wouldn't die, and he'd still get to clear the board. Sure, it'd ramp for his opponent, but Mike doesn't have anything on his team that costs more than 4, so ramping isn't that big of a deal.
Right. Mike benefits more from having higher churn from keeping the sidekicks fielded.
Right, exactly. And which makes me think that the two bolts that JT's sitting on, he's going to use to just ping off the sidekicks this turn, especially since Mike missed all of his action dice.
Yeah.
Both polymorph and rally.
The rolls are already not being kind.
Mm-hmm. So what to do with 7 energy when you only have 4 costumes?
You regret not bringing Red Dragon.
Yeah, and you didn't get a shield, so you can't even buy the Paladin, which you're really looking forward to in the first place.
Yeah.
A phase. He set a bolt and 2 energy aside. He's gonna get the blue dragon. Yes, blue
get that dragon. Cyclic clearing out against that opposing Gabi.
Yeah, absolutely. It keep the Gabi down, clear a blocker when you're ready to go. Especially since he has 2 action dice in circulation already. Make that 3 action dice in circulation. He's got. Oh, JT magic missiles one of his own sidekicks. JT is desperately in need for that ramp. He's got to get to his expensive characters. So what do you think the chances are that JT's looking and hoping to get to that Jinzo since his opponent's bought 3 action dice?
Hopefully pretty good, because that's definitely going to start hurting Mike. But reaching for that 6 cost without any ramp is going to be a little rough.
It's true. I know this turn he can get another Gabi.
Certainly.
Or do you think he goes? Oh, he's rolled a sidekick. Bet he's going to try for that Umber Hulk.
Nope. For the Nova.
Oh, Nova. I guess he's got 2 Gabis. He's got 2 Gabis in circulation, is that right? So it's already a bunch of bolts for him to utilize. And
magic
with 3 characters.
On
yeah, Magic Missile and Cypher. And with 3 characters on the field, he's sitting pretty solid. Alright. Mike has a polymorph, but nothing in his use pile. So, best case scenario with what he's rolled right now is buy Constantine, poly in Constantine, which is a kind of expensive turn. What he might do is keep his double sidekicks mask and poly in the Gabi.
There you go.
Yep, there we go. Yep. That offensive polymorph use is really good against Gabi and is a solid move against Serena, so that's not terrible. Although JT still has more bodies in the field which is always going to be an issue. And our only mask global is Polymorph, right? So the mask that Mike is sitting on is relatively useless because none of his characters have levels.
Right. Well, there's six costs for that Jinzo right there.
Yeah, is it going to be the Jinzo, though, or the Venom? That's the question, right?
It's the Venom.
Yeah.
And Jinzo is Kobold, right? So he's gonna have a little rough time with that.
Yeah, though Mike does have two sidekick buffers, so if he can get Captain America and Angel on the field, he can have 1-1 sidekicks back, but I don't know if that's worth it. But it'd be really great if that's his strategy and he can poly out the Venom one turn or another, you know? And he does have the Green Dragon, which is a fist character. So that's another option.
Yeah.
And he bought a kobold. And it looks like he's going to rally another sidekick. So he's down to 5 sidekicks in the field, which is pretty good. Unfortunately, he's already bought 3 action dice, so he's still not, like, churning his entire bag every turn. He won't do that until he has all of his sidekicks in the field at this point. So it's rough. Let's see, JT gets another sidekick, and 3 energy. Interesting energy, shield, bolt, and question mark. Now, does JT want to buy another Gabi? Because that's a solid plan. Or does he want to thin his opponent some field by just pinging some dudes off?
Well, I think he's waiting on that Venom to come out, so that'll take care of everything all at once.
True. Actually, you know what I think he's waiting on? He's going to attack the Gabi, and if it goes unblocked, he's going to pump it with anger issues. If it goes blocked, he's going to ping it so it dies to a sidekick. That's my prediction. No, he passed the turn. Never mind. So Mike rolls absolutely nothing he wants except the double energy on Rally, but no Polymorph. Rough days. So, Mike, if he wants to breath weapon this turn, has to burn one of his generic energies. And
right, so he moves to purchase an angel to use it up.
Yeah, which I think technically means one of the 2 generics that he has right there is already spent, so he can't breath weapon now because he bought an angel.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. It's so rough. He can't even breath weapon this turn. And if Venom is one of the 4 dice that JT draws from his, how many does he have in circulation? 5. Well, I guess it'd be 8. Okay. He blue eye, or he magic missiled his own Gabi with his 3 sidekicks in the field.
But now, Mike has just named Gabi with Constantine.
Solid plan, although I would have named Venom, maybe? I don't know, let's see. Uh-oh. There's a Gabi and a Nova, and JT decided to keep the bolts. Oh, but he lands more bolts. So now he has 7 energy, 2 masks, and 5, well, 4 bolts and a question mark. So, what do you buy with a bajillion bolts?
Clearly the right move is Slifer.
What do you think the chances are that he will buy a Gabi and then just save the other 4 bolts for killing something in defense, like killing the dragon before Mike can attack next turn? Or okay, JT buys a polymorph guy. He's still sitting on 3 bolts and a question mark. That's a solid plan. Polymorph is target removal, which is, other than magic missile, is relatively lacking. And with right. No targeting protection, like Raven or anything like that, there's nothing really protecting you from polymorph other than good bag management, which is really hard to do when there's absolutely no ramp for it.
Yeah.
Although, yeah. So I will say, Mike being able to rally out his dudes, makes bag management pretty easy to do. Cause he's always filling his bag, right?
Basically, yeah.
Cool. Mike was able to get a kobold face, so he'll at least have a blocker that can survive Venom landing. And his rally does not land again. Although, to be honest, he will only get one sidekick out of it, so. He now has 2 generics, a question mark, and a bolt. Does he buy a kobold and breath weapon with the generics and then save the bolt for magic missile?
I don't know.
That dragon's only a 4/4, right? So what I would do maybe is keep the question mark to polymorph global if my opponent lets the dragon through and takes it to the face, because 6 damage on that level 3 dragons is a solid hit.
Yeah.
I don't know, we'll see.
Grabbing the last polymorph.
That's the last polymorph. Interesting. JT passes priority, JT is past priority and then, spends 4 bolts to kill the dragon. If I were Mike, I would have interrupted to do that polymorph trick that we just talked about, but.
Exactly.
That yeah. would but then mean, that would then mean. Play. Right. That would then mean that there's no breath weapon incoming this turn, which was JT's plan in the first place. So either way, JT wins that exchange. Yeah. So Mike decided to buy another kobold, which I think is a solid play, especially since look at that. JT just rolled Venom and Serena, which is a solid hit this turn. If he could, oh, nope. He did not land the Serena. Excuse me. We see Mike is still at 18. Level 2 Constantine survives. And JT is happy to clear the field, and is allowing Mike to take his turn. So Mike will be rolling 10 dice this turn. Solid turn for Mike. Can you see what level that Venom is on? It was 1 fielding cost, so he's a level 2.
Yeah.
Let's see. Mike has, oh, He triggered the swarm from that kobold he impulse bought last turn, so nice payback right out the gate. Now, Mike also was able to land an angel so that all of his sidekicks will be getting plus one, but I believe that's only when angel attacks, correct?
Right. Right. So
the good news though is he
sidekicks stay in the field against that.
The good news though is that is a polymorph he just landed, so he can poly that venom out and the gobby back in, and not have to worry about the gobby doing damage to him and get the venom board control off the board. So it's kind of a win-win there.
Right.
And Mike has his own polymorph to use on top of that.
There you go, just like you said. So yep. You can tell that Mike's a very comfortable player with polymorph.
Yep, absolutely. Angel gets fielded. Now, what is Mike gonna buy? So what is Mike gonna buy that he wants to poly right in? Is it gonna be, do you think it's a blue dragon? Because honestly, if it was the blue dragon, I think he made a misplay. I think better for him would have been, to buy the blue dragon and poly it in first and then poly out the venom. Because then he could have made one target not able to block. Although, it's only sidekicks. No, it's the Gabi left, right? So he could have made the Gabi unable to block.
Right.
Oh, no. So it's a human paladin.
Okay.
Good news, bad news on the
human. Worried about the ping globals.
Yeah. Good news, bad news on the human paladin, though, is at level one, he just dies to venom. So that's rough days.
Oh, yeah.
And JT's bag is empty, so he'll be refilling it with everything this turn, which means Venom will be coming right back around. And Mike is sitting on one question mark just in case. And he's gonna name Serena. And JT pinged the sidekick at the end of his turn to give him a little bit of extra ramp. JT's got Serena, which he's rolling for, but misses, grabs a sidekick, and 5 energy. 2 fists, 2 shields, and a question mark. What are you gonna do, JT? JT buys an anger issues and keeps a question mark. Anger issues is a pretty solid way to use globals against your opponent without being able to target your opponent's dudes, because you pump up your characters instead of having to try to ping down the opponent.
Right. Yeah, that's a way to use anger issues that I'd never thought of before against human paladin.
And JT's attacking with Gobby with one question mark, and it's a 2-2 Gobby, so if Mike blocks with anything, Gobby's gonna die.
Yeah.
And so Mike lost the opportunity here to block with, anything else, and deny JT that extra energy. On the other hand, JT was able to threaten the other three characters with that one ping. So really the best block would have been Constantine. Although anger issues pump on his character would cause both of them to get knocked out, or Paladin would just get knocked out, or Kobold would just get knocked out. So, That's why he threatened. Meanwhile,
he's managed the best to turn burst on both rallies.
Double burst on both rallies with actually 6 sidekicks in the reserve and 3 kobolds in the used. And 3 kobolds in the used means he gets to put 6 sidekicks onto the board, this 7 sidekicks on the board this turn because he rolled one naturally. And the rest of his turn, he's got 4 kobolds, 3 kobolds in circulation, so he's probably going to get everything this turn. And that's assuming he doesn't just win anyway because JT only has 2 dudes. So, Mike is attacking with 7 sidekicks and Angel. That's 15, 14 or 16 damage, and JT can't even ping. JT blocks Angel, because Angel's slightly more damaged than the rest. And JT anger issue buffs his sidekick, so that at least he trades a sidekick. And JT takes 12 in one solid hit, putting the pressure on. And Mike names Gabi with his Constantine effect, and JT is rolling Nova and Venom and Gabi. And on his first roll, lands a sidekick, but decides to re-roll his Gabi. Still lands the Gabi, but does land the Venom. Yes. He also gets one of each energy type, except Mask, which he makes up for with his question mark. And an extra bolt with his single bolt face Nova. Venom knocks out a human paladin, and that's it. Just the human paladin. So, solid there. It does mean Constantine can get KO'd while Venom is still out, but we will see. JT makes a much smarter move and pings the kobold, knowing that there are
3 in use.
A bajillion dice in Mike's bag right now.
Yeah.
And Venom, like I said, the downside of polying in the paladin is Venom makes it easy. Alright, we'll see what Mike is able to luck into on his 4 dice out of 12. Or 16, or however many it was that he had. and he's able to get a polymorph.
Yeah.
And 3 sidekicks. Let's see if he can land the polymorph. No, but he does get a paladin and 2 kobolds. And a sidekick. Oh, I'm sorry, 2 sidekicks and a kobold. He's probably gonna put the kobold out there. He looks like he doesn't want the paladin, and I don't know why. Maybe it's instantly killed by Venom. If it's the level 1 paladin, he's going to want to re-roll it and hope to get anything higher. So, it looks like it is a level 1 paladin. Oh no, I'm sorry, it's a level 2 paladin.
Right. Because paladin costs 0 to field on his level 1 phase.
Right, absolutely.
JT reminds Mike that the sidekicks can't stay in the field.
Yep. Which is fine, it's prep for next turn.
Exactly, it calls your bag and it's ramp.
Yep, and especially with as messy as his bag is right now. And Mike is gonna Like, he's looking at maybe buying another angel, but... And that angel is when any angel attacks or when angel attacks. Like, do two angels attacking give each of your sidekicks +1/+1?
Or is it... No, because it has the reminder text, no matter how many angel dice attack.
Okay, right. Back when they hadn't quite realized that win attacks abilities should be for each angel, or for each character attacking.
Right.
Mike is debating what to name for his Constantine this turn. Dobby's in the field, so there's no obvious answer. JT just gets a bunch of sidekicks, though, and a... anger issues? Is that anger issues?
I believe so.
I know he did buy a polymorph, so that might actually be a polymorph he bought. I think anger issues is a slightly darker blue. Let's see. He got a sidekick and immediately put it in the field. He's now got a question mark, a bolt, and... Can you tell if that's an action face?
I think it's too energy. It looks too round to be an action face, but it's a little blurry on my end.
Fair enough. I don't think JT's going to make any aggressive moves this turn. He may try the Gobby trick again and attack to try to get his Gobby bounced so that Mike constantly has to name Gobby with his Constantine every turn. And worst case scenario, JT gets some bolts, and can ping off things if he can. JT's making an observation here. Mike's bag is chock full, but it's not chock full of bad stuff. Almost everything Mike can draw into is solid and good for his team. So JT's a little bit worried about what all the options that he could encounter are next turn. And so I think JT's just gonna just sit on everything he has and hope to use it defensively and weather the storm, as it were. And one of the reasons that JT is so worried about Mike's bag is, as you can see, he just swarmed twice this turn. So that's 8 dice Mike is rolling. And while they're mostly sidekicks, he's got 2 action dice there in the mix that could be causing the ruckus.
Right, he's got the 2 sidekicks and used for rally and... Oh, but JT doesn't have any valid targets in his use pile for an offensive polymorph, so...
Right. That's a fair point. But Mike could get Green Dragon and Breath Weapon for 2 and knock out a bunch of stuff. And Mike can rally if he could... what level is that, that Venom at?
Honestly, costs 1 to field and it's on burst, so it's level 2.
Right. So with a fist and 4 bolts, Mike could brute force the Venom off the board, as rough as that is, and then rally and swing again. Because he's only got 3 bolts. He had 1 more bolt. Because he can use the Venom Global to spin Venom down, right? And then he can ping, ping, ping. And you have to remember here that JT is at, 8 life? So if he can just keep the pressure on JT, Mike has a significant advantage.
Right. I mean, at this point, I think he should have a blue dragon coming out next turn, which will clear out JT's sidekicks, and if he can get that Venom off the board so that his entire field stays, then that should do it.
Yep, absolutely. Now, Mike decided to rally just to prep dice, so he rallied them into Venom, at which point they immediately KO'd and auto-prep.
Right, they sort of functioned just like PXG then.
Yep, and then he used his bolts to ping off the sidekicks, and my thought is that it's because he's going to attack with one of his kobolds, and then pump that kobold if JT blocks with Venom. Or, you know, I could just be totally wrong, and he goes and buys a Captain America instead.
I think you and Mike have very different play styles, so it's interesting to contrast what he thinks to do and what you think to do.
Yeah, because if he'd attacked with, like, Angel... Wait, who did you just... Oh, he did still attack with that. He did still do the attack. He just knew that JT was only going to block with Gabi, and he didn't have two blockers to force in, or two attackers to force in, because he wants to sit on the Angel.
Right.
Personally, I would have stuck with the Angel, because Angel plus four is almost lethal. So he named, I believe, Serena this turn.
I couldn't quite catch it. My audio dropped out.
Yeah. Yep. Now, JT has Nova, three bolts, and a Gabi he really wants to get KO'd. So, this looks like it's going to be a dangerous turn for Mike. JT, on the other hand, has to debate. Okay, so Serena is a level 2. She's a 2-2, and Mike is trying to decide who he wants to block with and if he wants to spin. So he spends down his Angel, which I believe was at level 3, so that he's now level 2.
And he's taking the damage to send Serena to use.
Yep.
Which gives him a polymorph target next turn for that Venom.
That's a very solid point. Additionally,
oh, but JT's just done the math that
there's not a chance that he could get poly. Because
they're both
five dice in the bag.
He's got too much in the bag.
Yep, absolutely. On the other hand, like I said, he could do the brute force method to get sidekicks this turn, which would be interesting, if he could get enough bolts. But I don't know that he sees that option. We will see what he thinks. He would need to reroll both those masks and the blue dragon to try and get the energy he needs. It's such a clutch. Like, he'd have to get double energy on blue dragon and a bolt on one of the two masks, which is really rough.
Right, that's a fairly low probability.
Yeah.
But he's still sitting at 16 life, so I don't see an easy path to victory for JT next turn either.
Well, JT's hoping that Mike attacks with anything this turn so that he can gauge the threat and ping with Nova and do 6 this turn. So dropping him from 6 to 10. Mike rallies to prep some more sidekicks and then is back again. And now he has... And then he fields 2 more to prep 2 more. Mike is apparently really good at sidekicks, you guys.
You know, he really should have brought Human Torch for this game.
And that looks like it's a level 3 Green Dragon.
Yeah.
And I would not attack with it because you'll take 8 damage from Nova. 1 from Breath Weapon, and then 3 more from the 3 bolts that that JT has pinned. So unless he can, like, lethal Mike or JT this turn, I wouldn't even make the Blue Dragon move. Because he didn't. Also, he played the action die after he fielded the dragon, or before he fielded the dragon. He could have made it so Nova couldn't block.
He could have had this turn. He could have had lethal this turn.
Well, remember, JT can. No, JT can't ping off dudes. So, yeah. Yeah. Would it have been lethal? Because, I mean, it would be the kobold and, like, Constantine, who does 0 damage, that would be unblocked, right?
Oh, I forgot the venom was still in the field. So you're right. No, he wouldn't have had lethal. He's got to get that venom out of the field.
Right.
I always forget that the venom affects the attack as well.
Ooh. Mike does not attack, so JT does not get a chance to trigger Venom, or trigger Nova, which is good for Mike, especially as clean as his bag is looking right now. JT does get his anger issues this turn, though, and that may be a really solid move for JT this turn. Maybe. Because you put Overcrush on the Nova? Or even the Gabi. Gabi's about to become a 7-3. Maybe an 8-3. It's a rough. That Blue Dragon is actually only a 4-4 because of the -2/-2. I wonder if it's worth just taking the Gabi on the chin this turn. Not letting anything get KO'd. Like I said, it'd be 8 damage, but that would put him at 8. It'd actually be 9 damage because the better move would be to ping Nova.
Yeah.
So 4-4 with a +1. Yeah. So it's 7-4 is total of 5 damage to Mike this turn, which will drop him down to 11, which is still a huge move, considering he had to lose the dragon not to take 4 more. So Mike should be at 13, right? Because he took 5 from 18. He should end up at 13.
I think I missed something on the life calculation, so I'm not sure what's going on.
Oh, so JT used anger issues on Gabi, and then used a fist to pump him 1 more, so he's a 7-3. And then, and then Mike also just used Paladin's ability to reduce Nova's damage from 2-1. So, and did Mike take 2 damage earlier? Was there a reason he was at 16?
I think there was a Serena that he let through a few times.
Oh, no, he, he didn't spin down for Serena one time, or yeah, he let her through. All right. Yeah. So that's why he's at 11, not 13. Check. We're good.
So he draws the storm and a swarming kobold, along with
He got the storm? But that storm can't survive in the venom. So that's not what he wants. Oh, he's got the four bolts. He's got the four bolts, but does he see it? He's got six bolts if he wants them. And an extra angel. No rally, no polymorph. He does have an extra kobold. He could reroll the dragon and hope to get the dragon. And still keep all the bolts that he wants.
Yeah.
But more importantly, he can reroll the storm and have a chance at being able to spin Nova off the field before Nova can do anything. Because JT has, what, one energy?
Well, that's the, when a storm attacks.
Right, well, I was thinking that JT could ping her off before she attacks, but Paladin says no, so that doesn't help. You see Mike is setting aside four bolts and a fist. That's death to a Venom. That's five energy to just clear Venom completely. He's rerolling his storm and his extra masks. He got the storm. This is pretty close to being game.
And there's the Venom off the field.
Yep. He fields all his things, passes. Wings forces a reroll on Nova, who gets prepped. Oh wait, oh no, he got bigger, sorry. It's a 7-7 Nova. Oh, and JT secedes and Mike wins. That was a really tough game. Lots of options. First
so
turn.
JT opens with a polymorph buy. Always a solid choice.
Absolutely.
Is it though?
Yes, Mike rolls.
God.
Mike rolls ? Bolt mask, buys the other polymorph and a kobold. One step ahead.
You'd think they would have just bought rallies.
Rally was super good. Buys a Serena and fields two sidekicks. He's getting ahead in the sidekick game. Who needs a rally when you can just actually roll sidekicks for realsies, guys?
And we're all silent and awe as we wait to see what Mike decides to do on his opening.
Mike buys the rally and fields a sidekick of for himself.
Action dice aplenty.
Yeah, we were wondering if JT was going to get that Jinzo with Mike buying so many action dice. Maybe he will.
Yeah, Jinzo would do some work.
Well, he can buy his Gabi now.
Yep.
JT gets two more sidekicks and misses his action die, so buys Gabi a Gabi.
This is going to be a repeat of the Phantom game where he ends up with a field of seven sidekicks, a Gabi, and then like an action die in the bag.
Yeah. Crazy game.
Maybe this one will end faster.
Yeah. Well, they do seem to be playing fast. No thinking, just roll, play. I hope you want shields, Mike.
Who doesn't want shields?
Well, he got a sidekick, so now he's got two to JT's four.
Got to get Constantine here, no question.
Yeah.
Yep. He's got to get a Constantine. Does he get the kobold too? Yep.
Yep. Yeah, he...
Which is good, because he's got a kobold already in the bag.
He needs that Constantine before Gabi starts taking advantage of him quickly.
Yep, absolutely.
How many sidekicks does he have? Polymorph. Jeez.
He does have a polymorph, so maybe next turn he can...
unlimited confidence in rolling sidekicks, so...
Unlimited sidekicks.
Ooh, I don't know if that was a solid move, but JT pings off both of Mike's sidekicks.
Whoa, first blood.
He attacks with just one sidekick and is able to get two anger issues buffs onto it for three damage. Yep. Yeah, that's pretty solid. On the other hand, Mike has, I believe, Polly and six energy, right? So he can buy Blue Dragon, Polly him in, and Breath Weapon this turn. So that might be something.
Or Polly and then Gabi.
Oh, true. He could aggressively poly Gabi. I was just thinking he could poly the Blue Dragon and clear the board.
Yeah, but that super ramps him into Jinzo.
Fair point.
It's important to note that JT is using his five-sided sidekick dice, where five of the six sides are sidekicks, one's a question mark. So
it's legal in Canada, so it plays.
Those are legal dice to play for all TRP-sanctioned events.
Instead, he wisely polys in the Constantine and can just...
Which none of us talked about.
Exactly. And is able to clearly buy all of his kobolds, so he's going to draw like nine dice next turn.
And that's why we're commentating and not playing.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly.
I see he's rocking... Mike's rocking two of the three Rainbow Draft Weekend cards on his team. He's just missing that magic.
Yeah, if JT would have ran the correct magic missile, we'd be fine.
I know. Too bad he didn't win it.
Ooh. That's okay. I have a second one he can buy off me.
It's a rare card out there. There are no more coming out, I've learned in the recent past.
Yeah.
Is that from your whammy board?
It's
an Ouija board, whatever you call it.
A Ouija board? Is that what you're trying to say?
Ouija board, yeah, there you go. Whammy.
All right, so JT buys another Serena and what?
Oh, wait, there's a game going on. JT bought a Serena.
There is?
Yep.
What was the action die that he... Did he poly something out?
Yeah, he polyed Mike's Constantine out for a kobold.
Gotcha. Solid.
Thanks for paying attention to us.
No kidding.
Absolutely. Why'd we bring these guys?
For, right?
Exactly.
Why'd we bring these guys in here? Just to like...
That's what I was just thinking.
Because we're awesome?
That's what I was thinking. And apparently. Mike gets his ideal roll of one fist on the kobold.
I'm assuming it's a character on the Constantine.
Yes, it's the worst guy like to play online with is Constantine. Oh, he's keeping the fist.
Yeah, I think when Mike was playing with Serenas on that map, it was impossible to realize that he even had the die on the map because it's so dark with Batman. But Constantine is still worse.
Yeah.
And for those of you that are joining us for Game 2 now that watched Game 1 in all of its glory, it looks like Mike's mat is backwards now and kind of flipped around. So it's the same team. Just looks different now.
You mean right words?
Yeah, it looks correct.
Looks.
It's not mirrored upside down and backwards.
All right, Mike buys an angel so that he can end up buffing his sidekicks and... Yeah, and he's polying his kobold down to spin his Constantine up, I believe.
JT
just admitted to being retarded.
Yeah, JT goes all PC correct on his commentary here.
Yep, absolutely. No, I'm not. But
wait, can they hear what JT and Mike are saying?
No, they sure can't.
Oh, perfect. Mike just said, this is the turn I'm going to kill you next. Be ready.
That's actually not what he said.
JT said,
oh, wait, so on the other hand, JT can... Then?
No.
Correct.
Oh, that's no fun.
JT I mean, can, however, that, get but... himself a Gabi. The question is
uh-oh.
I'm pretty sure that Gabi was Constantined.
He's got a polymorph up. Ruh-roh.
Polly's Constantine out for a kobold, but the effect is still in play.
Crazy rule.
And JT's trying to decide which kobold he wants to ping off, whether it's the level one or the other level one.
Right now, JT is inquiring on the number of dice in his Mike's bag. Mike told him to check the team sheet if you really want to know. So JT is currently checking the team sheet. We need to give him just a minute.
And the answer is five. There are five dice in Mike's bag.
Exactly.
You can't see off screen is his abacus that he's counting from.
I have an abacus. Those things are awesome.
Of course you do.
Would you get with a sentry and use a slide roll?
No kidding.
No. I actually got my abacus in Chinatown in LA when I was like 12.
So JT didn't even field Gabi.
He decided to save the energy instead of using it on the fueling cost, and then it swings with Serena. Mike takes all of it to the face.
Which is a total of 17 damage, I believe.
Oh, no, my bad. He blocks her with a kobold and a sidekick.
Well,
and JT pings off both of the kobolds, allowing...
Well, no, he just takes out the blocking kobold and pings off the other one.
He clears all the sidekick or all the kobolds off the board this turn, so there's no swarm. Unfortunately for JT, that there are also just three kobolds in the prep area, so there wasn't a lot of swarming to happen anyway. He misses one swarm die. Mike lands another kobold, and then the three single fist faces on the other three kobolds.
Perfect.
Oh, so good. The best.
Around!
So, Michaela, if you're sitting in Mike's shoes, what are you looking to buy next?
It's tough, because I'm just not super familiar with his team.
He needs a paladin.
You know, I think he needs to start pivoting to a win condition now. And oh, so he's got the angel. He's having a lot of trouble with JT's ping globals right now, so human paladin might be a solid next goal to hit.
And I think having seven sidekicks in the field will help him be able to buy whatever he wants.
Yeah, no kidding.
I mean, preferably whatever he wants that costs fist energy, because all he has left is kobolds.
He's got three fists and a question mark.
Which is going to be...
So, Paladin?
Hopefully or... Paladin, but possibly Captain America.
There's the Paladin.
I would argue that Captain America would be just as useful, but...
It really, yeah, it depends on your playstyle, whether you're wanting to take more of a defensive control approach here, or if you're really trying to pivot to a win condition faster.
Captain America doesn't protect his kobold, though, so that's the trade-off there.
Right.
And JT lands two Serenas. Then pings off the kobold so that nothing can spin down. So there's a level 2 and a level 3 Serena. It's going to be an immediate 4 damage to Mike, plus another 5 threatening.
Those Serenas are just nasty. I really continue to be surprised at the lack of play those get in WKOs or any type of unlimited play.
JT banned Mike's Serena and Gabi from this game, as well as his transfer power. So, oof. Mike just takes it all of it. Yeah. And then JT's got Mike's got a polymorph out and then three more dice coming. We'll see what they are. Hopefully one's not Rally at this point. One is Angel. Even if he misses
he's
Angel.
He's not going to have enough bolts, though. Well, take that back. No, he's only got one bolt.
Yeah.
He won't be able to clear enough out.
I don't know does he need the bolt if he gets Angel and can poly in a cap so that all his sidekicks are 3/3s. Like, I guess there's five of them. So he'd only get through 1, 2, 3, 4 characters. I mean, do you buy cap and just hope you survive the Gabi / Serena that's coming through? That's pretty scary. You would need to clear some of those sidekicks. You would almost have to attack this turn. Good news is
any, when he took all that damage.
Any sidekicks that block this turn stay in the field to block next turn, or that get blocked this turn stay in the field to block next turn, so that's advantageous.
He can only spin down once though if he does get more Serenas,
right?
I mean, one Gabi and it's over basically.
Well, and Angel doesn't buff the sidekicks unless he attacks. So JT would be best to just let the Angel through, and then there's nothing that can spin down.
Yeah. Take as much as you can.
Yeah, the secret here is to take all but one. Although
I would just take 11.
Mike has two fists in reserve, so if JT takes too much and doesn't count it, which he won't, but if he doesn't, then Mike can pump.
I would block one sidekick, maybe.
Basically, Mike has 19 damage on the board right now. Yeah.
JT has decided to go with the risky play and declare no blockers.
That's awesome.
Isn't Mike... He's sneaking through 19, right?
Yeah, Mike's going to get through 19, yeah. Leaving JT at 1. And JT has 5 on the board. So JT needs to roll 1 damage. He kept to try to mitigate, right? Now JT has to get 2 damage.
With Gabi.
Which he has to land Gabi and or 2 sidekicks. And that's a polymorph. It doesn't help to poly anything in. Yeah.
Poly a Serena in.
Oh, true. He could poly in nothing else.
No, right, nothing. He doesn't have a fist.
He's got to reroll. He's trying to decide if he wants to reroll for the right energy to poly something in, or if he wants to reroll for Gabi.
And there's
He's
Gabi.
His bets. There's Gabi. Gabi itself isn't lethal. He would have to swing.
I think it's a level 3. It's a 5/5.
Right. There's no opposing field to block, so that's
right.
Exactly.
Yep.
Yeah.
That was a much faster game.
Much faster game.
And we're back!
Game 3 for the championship. Game 5.
What? JT's going to formerly Weapon 10 this game.
Formerly Weapon 10. Turn 1.
He's going first, and there's no ramp, and there's no rip. Why not?
Yep.
A cobbled. I still don't get that.
JT buys anger issues. guess so, we know how this one's going.
Does anyone else say cobbled?
I say cobbled.
Just making sure.
Because it's an O, not a U.
You're a U.
He is indeed.
Very good.
And you wish you were a me. Hey, does anybody realize that Isaac's not here?
Can you not? Can you not hear me?
What?
We can now.
I was choosing not to talk. Oh, I was taking. I was taking the in the game. I'm like you guys.
So Mike got a kobold, missed his polymorph, which he probably really wanted to be able to Constantine that Wolverine, and is sitting on 4 energy, 2 of which are question marks, fortunately, but a Wolverine's still going to hurt.
Actually, I was distracted because Aqua Teen Hunger Force is on the TV, and I was...
Oh, dude, I love it. I was
looking at Shake, so sorry.
Shake Master.
Shake Master with the Boost Mobile.
So if he keeps the 2 question marks, that does give him a possible chance to be able to ping Wolverine off the board.
Yeah. But...
How's Meatwad in that episode?
No, he's not saving them. He's buying another Polymorph.
Yeah, Polymorph and a Kobold. He's hoping he can just survive.
JT did not draw either the Wolverine or the Anger Issues.
But he does get 2 sidekicks, which might help him get to lethal.
Master sidekick.
He grabs a Serena to keep the aggression and the pressure up and running.
Was that Master's Lord Alliance Serena?
I think
no,
she's...
No, that's Peace Serena, the Protection Serena.
Oh, Protection Serena. Peace Serena.
Peace Serena.
That's Fat Serena on the table right there.
How many silent letters can we put in front of a character's name?
Yeah. Fat with a P, so protection.
Protection. Full art Serena. And Mike has decided...
Fat Rena.
Mike has successfully rallied 2 dudes. Solid. Now he can again keep 2 bolts.
Does he ever rally?
Mike is going to sit on the defensive rally, pieces. But... Sit on the defense, Mike.
Yeah. You've got Polly coming. Okay. Here he comes.
You missed the anger issues.
No anger issues, right?
Right.
Nope. So he's just going to get the Wolverine on the board this turn.
Level 1.
1 to field Wolverine. 2 to buy another screen. Or ping off a kobold. Yeah, it's going to ping off kobolds. JT is mean like that.
Cubold.
Cubol.
Professor X. And Wolverine's going to sit there.
He's just waiting.
He's got 2 defense on level 1, right?
Yep.
Right.
Yep.
Just 2.
So
that's a single magic or a double magic missile ping and make him re-roll and refield him.
What's this attack? Is it 6 or is it 4?
17.
4, but he gets... It's 4, but he gets plus 4.
Plus 4.
He gets plus 4.
Yeah. It's 4, 6, 8, right?
5, 6, 8.
5, 6, 8. Right.
5, 6, 8.
Yeah, because minimum is 9. That's right. Because that's what.
Well, we know why he's Mike, keeping two bolts. Say,
Mike's got the bolts. He just needs to reroll that action die. That's a polymorph, right?
Yeah, it's a polymorph.
And it's energy.
So he buys an angel. Or Constantine, yeah.
Kobold.
He fielded a kobold. He's taking Wolverine out now on his turn.
I don't understand that.
I don't either.
Nope.
That's a mistake.
Yep.
But that's okay.
Well, Wolverine's really expensive to field, right? So if you,
yeah, but if he gets
if you
the...
take him out.
Because the anger issues now.
With the level 2 or 3. He's already got,
yeah, but that's,
he's got crazy
that's
ramp
less,
over there.
That's less fists that he can pump, right? Like,
oh, and Serena, that could be game right here.
He didn't get, no.
Oh, wait, no, if he attacks alone.
No anger. Oh, no, there's the anger issues.
Yeah, but he missed
didn't get either one of them, though.
JT's going to go for that second roll. Rolling the Wolverine comes up.
Boom. And did, so did Serena. So he
but
basically
he
can just a field,
to get the
just afford to field this turn.
Yeah, level 2.
Oh, that's a level 1 Serena, I believe.
Yeah, see it for free. So that's a 10-6-7.
He's a 10-7. Soon to be a 13-7.
About to be a 13-7.
rough days
so
ahead.
He's going to hit for 9. I mean, do you just let it through?
Mike expressed his displeasure with the attack. I don't think you can let it through because a couple of those and he's done.
Yeah, like you could block with the 2 sidekicks, but I would not
yep.
block with the kobold.
He took it all.
Took it all.
Yep. Yeah, you definitely don't want to lose
he
the
can
level
spin
3
down
kobold.
Twice on the next arena.
You definitely don't want to lose the level 3 kobold because that's 4 damage you prevent from Serena. At the least 2 and a ping from JT. Ooh, he gets it. He got rally with everything. He can clear the board. He can hit back for 1, 2, 3, 4. What's that? 16?
Well, he can't clear. He can only take out 1.
Oh, right. Yeah.
He's only got 1 bolt.
But he can
but
clear.
He's got a pump.
He can clear this arena. Oh, cold. No attacks this turn. Plenty of blockers, though.
Come on, JT. You already asked that last turn.
Yeah. JT doesn't save information that he can ask his opponent in his memory. Oh, JT uses Venom's Global
so
to
pings off the kobold.
Move the kobold. Yeah. Mike has 3 dice clogging up his bag. And And he takes two because he has nobody to spin down. And he blocks with Angel and a sidekick.
So what, he's got a sidekick, a kobold, and a poly in his bag, right?
I do believe so.
Sidekick, kobold, poly. So. Yep. And there's not really anything to poly offensively for. So hopefully he gets a win condition. He is rolling a ton of energy this turn.
He's got to try to poly a Constantine in just to slow it down.
That's true. I mean, unless he, since the board is relatively clear, I mean, maybe he can hit lethal this turn, but it's a big ask.
Not a good start.
So Mike has a big ask, we've learned. while we have a minute,
with the bad rolls and the clutch.
Yeah, exactly. He's rolling a Stewart. Keeping the fists.
Well, Stewart, how do you feel about having that named after you?
You know what? Not all of us need Parallax.
I know Dave went to Parallax so much as WKO.
There's a great video of someone Parallaxing eight or so times.
It was six.
At a big event.
And plead the fifth. YouTube.
Parallax also shot me in the foot at Worlds on stream.
Hey, it got me to where I needed.
Well, I was not fortunate enough to ever be on stream. No,
they didn't allow you. There's reasons. Says the guy who got to commentary on stream.
Yeah, but then I illegally commentaried, so it's okay.
It's all good.
So we got a blue dragon. He's just walling up. Waiting for that lethal strike.
Yep. So no, I haven't been happy with Mike's blue dragon play. He keeps playing rally before he fields his blue dragon. It's just, even if you're not planning on attacking this turn, it just seems
it's a bad habit.
JT lets out a deep sigh of confidence.
JT's going to do it again.
Hang off the level 2 kobold. You know, the kobold. No, I'm sorry, kobold.
He pings off the only character with a level before attacking again.
Higher than 1. Death by 1,000 Serena attacks.
Yeah, don't take too many when you get them big.
They do work.
They do work. Serena, she does work.
Often game.
Indeed, she's rolling. While we have...
She's quite active.
Oh my gosh. Yes, she is. While we have a minute, we'd like to thank our sponsors tonight. Toffs. Toffs Ice Cream. Yeah, Toffs Quality Ice Cream, Ohio's oldest dairy farm. Thank you, Toffs. I'm eating some Toffs ice cream right now.
Isaac is eating ice cream at the moment.
Also a sponsor of Veggie Straws.
I guess also, that's better than me eating baby carrots on stream last time.
We also like to thank Mentos, the fresh maker, for making each of your breaths tolerable tonight. Mentos. The fresh maker.
Even from a distance.
He is.
From a distance.
He's going the distance. Mike wishing his dice to roll what they need. And he lets out a tirade of profanity.
He got the shield to get the Captain America in, but not the.
Yeah, well, I think he's hoping for a bolt.
You just don't expect that kind of language out of Utah.
I know. I don't even know what 10 of those words were. JT reminds Mike that he would have won with Polymorph here.
How kind of him.
And then proceeds to remind him that he still has zero levels with which to spin down when Serena comes back again next turn.
Yeah, that's rough. That's not good.
Has he only just bought a Serena and a Wolverine?
He has two Serenas, I believe, but yes.
And anger issues.
Oh, yeah, and it's anger over. Issues, yeah.
He got the Overcrush, it's over. Yeah. See you. Good night.
Just add insult to him injury. Oh.
Oh, he can't field it.
He can't field it.
He's level 3.
But he's got the Serena and the Overcrush.
He's
so,
still got lethal, yeah. But yeah.
Mike.
Well, no, he doesn't. That's not lethal. He's enough blockers to take the Overcrush. He's going to get down to 1, though.
Yeah. Yeah. But the thing is he hasn't played Overcrush yet, so he has to put 4 defense in front of each of the sidekicks. So it's game because...
can't make
because
that.
Yeah, see, Mike, I even talked about doing that with anger issues the last time I was on a podcast. Nobody listens.
Nobody listens, indeed. Who are you?
Nobody listens.
Nobody listens. I'm just somebody that was on the street. You guys said you needed another voice for this thing.
Ah, that's
right. I don't even know how to play this game.
Wait, hold on. Yeah,
that's right. Most
we don't though. We don't talk about ladies on the street. This is a family Thanks. Podcast.
Indeed, thank you. This is a video.
I'm not gonna lie. I totally missed the whole attack with
this
everything.
This is a video podcast.
Miss it. I'm not smart enough.
No arguments there.
You are always smart enough. You have to believe in yourself.
Mike's slowly mathing out that they can all do 3, so he's realizing, nope, I can't.
All right. Let's just make a note that the last 2 games were still combined half of the first game.